Alright, as expected, Zilla was cleared of the allegations. If you guys haven't seen it yet, let's take a look at it. Excuse you, no. Off, ma'am.
Let me turn this down.
No, Maggie.
What up, guys?
You cannot be this close to me,
So,
though. No, your
I got
privileges are limited.
investigated for, so I couldn't say anything for super long. So now that I can say something after this investigation from court,
Boom.
they went through my phone.
Boom. Legal documents.
They went through basically everything that I have.
I knew it.
And I'm still like right here. And I got an order of protection. And they found no wrongdoing or anything. So, let's see. Let me grab these papers. Actually, counter. It's been fake news. And I have everything from court.
Boom. The allegations were false. He was not talking to the minors. People were were reporting rumors that he was talking to 15-year-olds and sending unsolicited messages and whatnot.
Of this whole like plotting, scheming, trying to get money out of me, all this blackmail, all this crazy stuff has basically been happening. But disorderly conduct, harassment, aggravated harassment in the first and second degree, identity theft, menacing, criminal mischief, and stalking.
Yeah. These are against the people, the perpetrators of Zilla, dude.
So, I also want to say anybody who was covering up a tattoo or anything, keep that appointment. And anyone who burnt my merch, keep that appointment. And if you were thinking of burning merch, go burn it. Because I don't really want you in my merch. You would think that I would do something like that. Everybody else knows me.
I'm talking about, dude.
You can also keep going.
I never believed it, dude. It always came off to me as another Trevor Bauer
Only
situation.
the age of said person, March 5th, 1995. I have full background of everything that happened from text messages. You can't really doctor text messages in court. It's not really how it works. So, of all these documents, I have documents of her last arrests, which she had eight, basically doing the same shit. I have text messages of her saying chink and nigger.
That's crazy.
Me a chink lover. And this is all the paperwork. I have so much paperwork that I'm getting confused right now. It's too much paperwork, actually. I can't show y'all this because it has addresses on it. Can't show y'all this. Let me see what I can show you guys. But for anyone who thought it was me or anything, there you go. I can tell you a whole story. I dated someone for a year. And they would ask me for money and all this stuff. Money, help with their brand, all this stupid shit. Which I didn't know she did
Oh.
to her last boyfriends, all that shit. Basically blackmailed me and was like, if you don't, I have the messages. Basically, like, if you don't, give me money and follow me. I will make it out that you're a pedophile. And I even hate saying that fucking word. Because that shit's kind of crazy. But I have all the. They printed out all the messages. Of black.
That's crazy, dude. Blackmailing him from the start.
Male harassment.
Glad the person I'm talking to isn't like that, man, you know what I'm saying? That's crazy.
Constant messaging, asking for money. Yeah, everything's like in court right now. Remember I said I was gonna go the legal route, guys? I did. Y'all just had to wait. And text messages are not something that you can delete. They always exist, so keep that in mind when you're doing weird shit.
Yo. 100%.
They always exist. You can't scrub them. Your phone service has them. So before I could even go to the courts and everything, before my lawyer even like would take it, he basically investigated me. I was like, we got to see if you're innocent, because we're not taking this. You're not innocent. And he did all that shit. We got an order of protection. She can't contact me. If she tries to talk about me or anything, she goes to jail. If she tries to have anyone else talk about me, she goes to jail. Basically all I could really do. I wish I could have talked to you guys before, but I was going through this fucking investigation and couldn't really do nothing. And if there's any more info that you need, I have everything. I'll literally get it posted. I'll ask somebody to post it. I don't want to really post it on my main shit because I don't want to give it that much energy. But if anybody has any questions, you can ask fucking questions. I have all the paperwork right here. It's a big ass stack of everyone.
It's a lot of papers.
Literally plotting against me and talking to each other on how to plot. Turns out she's 29. I have papers of her basically doing everything bad. Like anything bad that you could possibly name. Like, it's just blackmail spree and like everything. I met her at Utah Festival.
Damn.
And from then on, we were like talking. And then it started being blackmail. So I'm glad that some of you guys burnt your merch. Good. I'm so happy that you did that. Because now I can see who actually was like, really knows me. I have people like turn their back on me, who I gave opportunities to. I literally help everybody. That's my thing. That's literally all I do is help. So if you want to let.
It's true. By the way, if you ever get a chance, you should check this out. He's done several interviews in the past, but one of my favorite ones is his with, his collab with Brian Buckingham. He has multiple collabs, right? But there's one where they were training boxing. And that was probably my favorite video from them.
Like, I can name people, but I don't really want to do that. But whoever messaged me tried to call me crazy shit. Don't really care.
He did training and he also did an interview with him.
Because the truth obviously is out now. Everybody's trying to blackmail me and do stuff. So I don't give money to people. It's not a thing. I'm not giving anyone money. So you're not getting money. I lost, I lost my Zoomy stuff for this. I lost a lot of sponsors. They didn't even ask me about the
damn, situation. Damn, that's nuts, dude.
Basically lost like a tour. I had to step off tour. And that shit fucked me up, obviously.
Oh, just, no, that's
like,
had terrible.
I calm down and be like, oh, we're just gonna go the legal way because I'm not gonna just fight fucking people online when I know what the fuck happened. And I can just give somebody my fucking phone and they can see exactly what fucking happened. I can't really doctor shit, so I'm completely in the clear. My voice is fucked and my hearing is fucked from fucking porn. Yeah, and whoever, people were selling their merch, trying to get rid of all of it. I'm so happy that some of y'all got to buy it at like a discounted price, because that's even better. You should go to court, bro. Yes, obviously I went to court. I did all this while you guys were fucking flaming me and doing all this shit. I just went straight to the lawyer and just chilled. So I'm happy that
he knows how to stay quiet at the right situations. People could take a lot from this.
10,000 people in here. I'm happy that I got to see who actually is like real. And don't switch up now, because if you are on that side, stay on that side. And I kind of don't want you at my shows. People think that I'll do that. I kind of don't want you at my shows.
Never doubted for a second. Too.
All the producers hit me up. Well, some of them. They called me a...
He would never do something like that. Their
first opportunities and stuff. Peace out. I got to, like, nuke a bunch of people now. So a lot of y'all are, like, nuked. So, I'm so happy that people who hit me up, like, fucking Germ and Shoki and everybody, good people, hit me up, asked me what the situation was, got my side, didn't even do anything. We're like, oh, yeah, we're riding.
It's producers, Germ and Shoki.
I can't talk online all the time.
Some of them, at least. What about Thrax, dude?
Now I know my riders.
Do they have steam work still?
My brother, Chad, everybody. Them niggas stuck with it. Did all that good shit. And I don't know why you would think that I would do that when some of y'all, I stayed up certain nights when y'all would hit me up and be like, I'm about to kill myself. And I would stay up and talk to y'all all the fucking time and go out my way to be like, yo, I'm like a fucking, bro, it's like a diary. Like, you can use my DM as a fucking diary, bro. You're good. So, I'm just happy I have to clear the fucking air. Like, I can finally talk about this shit.
Yeah, I would never believe that.
I didn't know some people
that nonsense.
But I just know the people who stuck with it.
That was that was being told about them before.
Bro, all the people were commenting like, oh, fucking, you can't go the legal route. I seen people like, you're not gonna go the legal route. I just fucking went the legal route, bro. So.
He's like, damn right, I just did.
And also, all these pages who posted negatively about me.
What's all these messages about people saying Aku-san?
Never posted me before. When I dropped music, never posted me. So why now? There's like a YouTuber made 5 videos on it. You never talked about me before, so why now?
Protect your groceries, yeah,
it
kinda dude.
It shows me a lot about human nature and shit. So let me go through some of these documents. I don't really want the paperwork too much out there. I'll post it later.
Is that million views?
I'll someone else post it.
There was a lot of people. No, that's 10,000. Okay.
I also have the person's criminal history. Counts of assault. Counts of disorderly conduct. It's kind of crazy for someone who's 29 to be doing this to somebody.
10 million would have been a lot.
And to get an order of protection is not...
That's still a lot of people, too.
They have to be, like, tripping. They have to be, like, tripping. I have order of protection. I'm about to have a fucking restraining order. So... can't show y'all this. There's a bunch of addresses and shit I don't want to show everybody.
Yo, let's play Tarkov. Yeah, I don't think he's gonna do that with her. I mean, he might. I don't know.
I can't show y'all. Damn, there's so many addresses everywhere. But she has done this to multiple people. Man, I'm kind of like...
Does Zilla play Tarkov? Does anybody know? Chat, do you know? I know he plays League of Legends sometimes. I know he's played other games too, but Tarkov? I don't know.
If somebody from before who she's done this to would have stepped up and done what I just did, this wouldn't happen to me. So I'm kind of nipping it in the bud right now.
Wouldn't put it past him.
Because if I nip it in the bud right now, she can't do it again to anyone else. I just go the legal way. Anybody.
I've never played it personally. Sounds like a fun game though.
Talks. Basically, about me, jail. If anybody does anything about me, suing. I'm just going like straight up aggro mode because this shit's getting fucking annoying and it's fucking up my tours. My number was leaked, my address was leaked. She told people to come to my house.
Ooh.
Someone tried to vandalize my car.
Oh no.
The fuck's going on? So.
Doesn't he got, like, guns? Like, I wouldn't fuck with this guy.
Yeah, I am locked in, because this shit's fucking annoying.
He knows how to fight, too.
Someone tried to vandalize my car. People were trying to contact my parents' work. It's like I had to go to legal route. Yeah, so. Oh, y'all switched up. Bye. Peace out, man. Peace out. And I'm crucifying anyone else who does anything crazy to me. Like, you're getting crucified.
That's crazy.
It's a lot of like jibber
jabber. I can't wait for his next album, dude.
But other than that,
if he has a solo, if he does a City Morgue one, I hope he has a City Morgue one, dude. That'd
I'll post
the statement.
Probably like later.
We need that.
Everybody who sees the live knows that I'm fucking exonerated now. My tour's fucking canceled because of this.
Which That's is probably terrible. The
but I'm just gonna keep it rolling. I also found out that her leaking stuff, she was like leaking information that was getting my music leaked. So we know who is the reason that I haven't fucking been dropping music. Cause everything that I was doing was getting dropped. There was only like two people at my music. So that's why I haven't been making music. I actually went I went away for a minute and tried to like get my mind straight, because this is a lot. Like, this is a lot. Y'all got me fucking fishing. I never went fishing. And when people started wallowing on me, I was like, damn, I'm going to Legal Route, so I can't say nothing. What do I do? I had to fucking go fishing. Who the fuck goes fishing? That shit was so boring, but it was the only thing that I could really clear my fucking mind.
You went fishing.
Drinking a fucking beer and going fishing. It was the only thing that could clear my fucking mind. But I'll post whatever I can, because I can't really post too much. Now, fishing's cool, but it's just like, what am I doing? I'm not supposed to be fishing. When is Dog Years coming? Dog Years is gonna come back literally immediately. Because now that we're out of Zoomies, we have more freedom actually to do whatever designs like we want. We don't gotta make it like friendly. Friendly for every.
Yo.
But I basically got called every name in the book. I got called a woman beater. Which, if I really were to fight a girl, I don't think she would have like a little bruise on her, like little bruises. So maybe that's from Muay Thai class that we go to all the time. Maybe that's what that's from. Maybe because you have bruises on your leg from getting leg kicked in Muay Thai. I call it like a manipulator. I don't even talk. So who the fuck am I manipulating? And I got called a. I'm trying to list it until. I'm listening until ones that didn't hurt until.
I think I don't even talk. That's crazy.
Ones that, like, did hurt. What was I get called? Emotional abuser? I don't fucking talk. So where's the fucking emotional abuse? Then I got called a pedophile. Which is fucking crazy. I was like, what the fuck? But I found out everybody was like. Found out everybody was like plotting against me, trying to get money out of me, trying to fuel their fucking fuel their shit. And it was basically like, if you don't do this, then I'ma say this online. But I went to court and I'm chilling. So peace out, guys. All this canceling shit, fucking stupid. And what up, Nate Lavelle? All this shit's fucking stupid. I literally live with my parents. Like, I live with my parents. What the fuck am I doing? I got shit, fucking books, and stupid shit. I'm a normal fucking person. They're trying to make me out to be like some fucking Titan evil mastermind. Definitely not a Titan evil mastermind. But if you kind of make me. If you make me go to the mastermind area of this, I can be a real big dick if you fucking make me big, like. But everything's good in court. I'll make a fucking statement. Thank you for everybody who was chilling during this time. Does he not make money? Does he? I like being here, bro. It's peaceful. It's peaceful and nobody can really say anything about me. I'd be like, oh, he's a fucking dick. Did this. And it's sad that this is my first time being, like, in the fucking limelight. Nobody cared about me before this. Nobody gave two fucks about what Zilla was doing. So, I'll keep posting shit about this now, because I know some people aren't gonna see this fucking live. I know someone's gonna clip it.
Foreshadowing.
Well, let me show you the crest. so y'all know that I'm not fucking capping. Let me find it. The crest of it signed by the judge. And that music is Nujabes. Fucking, it's like a homework edit. Let me see if I can find this fucking paper. Sorry, the papers are getting all like jumbled together. Oh, here. Here's some cool shit. Fool me once, Bill Clinton. Now send me shit, you chink smasher.
Huh?
Send me shit, you chink smasher.
I wonder if she said this because he was in Thailand for so long. Mostly training Muay Thai, I'm pretty sure.
Also, anybody getting blackmailed by somebody? Just like, bro, just go to the fucking court. Go to court about it.
That part.
They'll find what's really going on. And they'll see you getting like, people trying to manipulate you and shit. Yeah, I can't find no press on it. I'll post it. I'll post it when I find everything. But, yeah. I have a lot of shit that I can, like, post. But I'm just gonna leave it at that right now. And I'll go live again and explain again. But for now.
It's so interesting how he does that with the toothpick. I think he's doing that because he does it as, like a way to, like, a replacement vice instead of smoking a cigarette.
I'm out of here. Thank you for who stuck around and actually defended me. You guys are cool, even though you didn't even know, you were just defending, y'all don't even know me, but y'all know I wouldn't do anything.
I don't even know what that is.
I talk to everybody. But, also I have messages between every girl talking to each other, and basically like trying to corroborate stories.
Yeah, I think it's too thick.
So, if any of them talk, jail. If anybody talks about me, jail. Jail.
Might be trying to get his gum out, yeah.
I hate going like legal routes because it's fucking stupid. But, peace out.
Yeah, that was interesting. What did you guys think? Drop a like on that. That's the original video that it is on. Right here is from the latest live from like 3 days ago. I know what you guys thought in the comments below. You know what I mean? You guys knew all along that he was innocent, or if you had your doubts, let me know. If you like the video, be sure to drop a like. Subscribe for more. And be sure to share it with your families. And peace out. Take and put out the grenade, nigga! I'm gonna go press on your grave! Okay, I'm tired of y'all niggas acting crazy and shit! We out here. Fuck you mean? When the doors come out, we ain't playing that shit! My niggas ain't scared! Beware, don't tear! Beware! Beware, don't tap, beware. One for the gang, two for the fame, three for the name, four to the grave.